Hello, everyone. The topic for today is how to write a perfect informal letter. In my previous video, I had explained on how to write a perfect formal letter, the link of which is given in the description box. Do have a look. The word informal means friendly and unofficial. So it is very clear that the person to whom the letter is being written, he or she could be a near and dear one for us. The person is known to us. It can be a friend or a sibling or a relative. So let's go through the essential points in an informal letter or the points to be remembered. Meanwhile, please like, share, give your valuable comments and do subscribe my channel if you find it useful and productive. So what are the points, important points in an informal letter? First is from address, second is date, third is opening salutation, fourth is body, fifth is subscription, sixth is parting salutation, seventh is name and signature, next is layout, next is punctuation marks, and the last is superscription. From address, this is very much similar to the formal letter. It is written because the receiver or the reader must know the sender. Also, it is mandatory because the reader would want to reply. And so that makes from address important or significant in formal or an informal letter. I have given an example here. Mr. Jim, the first line is the name of the person. In the second line, it is the room number and name of the apartment. The third is street name or the name of the lane. And the last is city or district with pin code. The next is date. Now, why is the date important? Why do we mention date in formal as well as informal letter? Date is important as the reader must know when the letter was written. It is important because if the sender may want the recipient to solve any issue within a stipulated time frame, the sender will know how many days are left for him to solve the issue. Suppose you can imagine that if your mother may want you to solve a problem or an issue within a deadline. So you have to know, the receiver has to know how many days are left for him to solve the issue. You can write the date in any format, which I have mentioned here, 12th February, 2021, or 12.3.2021, or 12/3/2021. But mostly we prefer the first one. Next is the two things to be avoided in an informal letter are to address and subject. To address and subject are mentioned in a formal letter only. We have to avoid that in an informal letter. Next is opening salutation. We often write a letter to very important or an authoritative person or a person in some important designation in a formal letter. So we have to maintain that kind of decorum and dignity when we are writing a letter to an authoritative person. So in that case, there are several salutations like His Excellency, the President of India, Dear Sir, Respected Sir, Reverend Father, Respected Sir, etc. That is a matter of etiquette or formality. Now, even in an informal letter, although it is informal or unofficial, we have to maintain some kind of formality even in an informal letter. So that is why we have to write these words like Dear Daddy, Dear Mummy, Dear Uncle, Dear friend, dear friend, Nina, etc. These are the kind of words that are used in an opening salutation in an informal letter. The next is body of the informal letter. It is again divided into three parts, that is introduction, main body, and conclusion. Why is introduction important? Because that is an etiquette. Etiquette means the proper rules to be followed. It is a must because that is a proper way to start the letter. It is not fair to jump directly into the matter when we are writing a letter. The next comes main body, that is the core or the important matter. It expresses whatever you want to clearly say. And the last is conclusion, which is again written as a formality. The next is subscription. It is also another matter of proper etiquette rules. It is written on the left side of the letter. Subscriptions vary according to the situation. The example is with love among near and dear ones, with prayers, etc., with due respect, with gratitude, with heartfelt condolences, etc. Yours faithfully. And you have to mention your name and signature. Signature is a standard procedure without which a letter is invalid. The next is parting salutation. It is also a form of etiquette or a polite behavior. There is a difference between the words used for parting salutation in an informal letter and a formal letter. In formal letter, we have to be very official and formal, but here we need not maintain that formality. It is a counterbalance to the opening salutation. This is indispensable, means important, unavoidable, as it denotes the relationship with the writer and the reader. You can see here, yours truly, comma, there has to be a comma after the parting salutation. Yours affectionately, yours lovingly, your loving friend. Always keep in mind that there has to be no apostrophe on top of the letter S. Next is punctuation marks. They are important in a letter, irrespective of formal or informal letter. Now, after an opening salutation or a parting salutation, as I've already said, a comma is used and not a full stop. The next is a proper layout. I have given the pictures of centralized and left alignment layout in formal letter. Please do have a look. The link is already given in the description. Now, why is layout important? That's a good impression that you are giving to the recipient. The design of the letter is important. Layout means the way in which everything is organized or structured. A good structure adds beauty and impression to the letter. As you have heard of a saying, first impression is the best and the last impression. Same way, at one glance, the receiver, whoever is receiving your letter, should have a good impression about the letter. Centralized layout is a traditional form, but nowadays we follow left alignment as a standard procedure. The next is superscription. It is the last but not the least. The address is superscribed on the envelope. It animates the letter. What is the meaning of animation? It adds color to the letter. It makes it more impressive. That is nothing but the name of the person and address. Miss Kamala, name of her street, room number, building, and her city. Instructions written on the speed post, registered post, they're all superscriptions. Did you understand the topic? If you did, please like, press the bell icon, give your valuable comments. See you tomorrow.